Welcome. The following video or audio are the study of the Bible, chapter by chapter, verse by verse of the King James 1611 Bible. Our family welcomes you to our household Bible ministry time. You may watch and listen with us. Our goal has been from Genesis to the book of Revelation. Each chapter by chapter we try. And topical preaching and teaching aids you can find by searching different topics. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Come and appreciate the word of God for our spiritual growth, our development in the word of God by these lessons. Please feel welcome to upload and share our Bible study with family and friends. Like us, subscribe, write a comment, let us know you heard the message. The video or audio are not copyrighted and should be used and not abused. Thank you.
We have a serious terminal condition. It is called death. It is caused by sin. Sin kills. And without Jesus Christ, you will burn in hell. I didn't say party in hell. I didn't say corrals in hell. You will burn in hell for all eternity. There will be no escape. The only escape from the gates of hell is today to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. That is the only way of salvation that must be done before you die. Before the Lord Jesus Christ comes for his church called the Rapture. If you've never trusted Jesus Christ and you die, or the Rapture happens, salvation will not be simple. In the event that you die, there will be no salvation. Now, if you want to go through 7 years of the tribulation period and trust what the Bible says and works, your conduct to the Jew, where today, if thou shalt believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, thou shalt be saved. That simple. It is not anything you can give. It is not anything you can do because it's already been done by God, by the love of God, that Jesus Christ suffered and died and bled for the sins of man. Yet the Bible says that there is a broad way that leadeth to destruction. And many will go there. And I see many here in Daytona Beach. You are going to Broadway. But you're not going to a theater. You're not going to a show. You are going to the way of destruction. Utter and total loss. And yet there's another way. There's the straight gate that leads into life. See, the Bible says the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God, the eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. The Bible does not give any form of life to anybody that goes into hell. And yet, the actual fact is, in hell you have eternal life. But with pain and suffering and torments and troubles, and God knows what kind of life is that. Yet, a life without pain, without suffering, of no sorrow, is eternal life with the Lord Jesus Christ and God the Father. And it's being offered to you right now, today, free of charge. your pride. Step out amongst the world and put your faith and your trust on the finished work of Jesus Christ to be saved. Step out of religion. Religion cannot save you. Step out of your savings, your checking, your stocks, your bonds. That's not going to save you. Many of you are worried about and concerned about those babies that were killed in Syria. Some of you are concerned about the whales. Why not are you concerned about your own soul? Those children that died without sin imputed to them in Syria are in with the Lord Jesus Christ. How are you doing today? Because if you die without the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, you will be in hell. Most of those children will be in heaven. There is nothing you can do about those children. There is something that you can do for your soul today. God has never called man to save animals, yet God sent His Son to save you. Satan's got you distracted on who really needs to be saved. God says in His Bible, His Word, the Lord Jesus Christ, you are more precious than the sparrows. You are a created being made for God for His honor and glory, and you fell through Adam. And in your fall, you will die unless you receive the gift of God, which is eternal life through Jesus Christ. And you will die. And you will face God. That God of the Bible, Jesus Christ, God Jehovah, it will not be Allah. It will not be Santa Claus. It will not be the Pope. It will not be Mary. It will be the God of the Bible, Jehovah, that you will face in the judgment that the Bible said, prepare to meet thy God. Thy God is the one that's found in this book, the King James 6011 Bible. He's not found in fairy tales. He's not found in missiles. He's not found in religion, but He's found in the very pages of His book given by the Holy Spirit. A God that's not found in your textbooks. How convenient. A God that made the fruits and vegetables that you are buying, that has given you the money that you're using to buy His fruit. The God that this nation was founded upon in 1620 by the pilgrims of the Geneva Bible, that's the God you're going to meet one day, and maybe today. And if you meet God without Jesus Christ, you will be cast off into hell. You can't go to the right or to the left and up. That's not the way of God. To believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. Matter of fact, when you do that crucifix sign, the Bible says, cursed is he that hangeth on a tree. You got to read your Bible. You got to know what religion's teaching you wrong and what God's teaching is right. The salvation is meant through Jesus Christ. It's not go up to the right, to the left. It's believe on Jesus Christ to be saved. It is nothing that you can do. It is nothing that anybody else can do that can save your soul but Jesus Christ. How's this for a great Easter message? We're talking about Jesus. Lord forbid if I were to hide eggs and make children go find them. No, that has nothing to do with the gospel of Jesus Christ. And that's an insult. to your children. You are sending your children to go get eggs. Then the way of biology, you are calling those children sperm. Because the only thing I know that goes after eggs is sperm. But you will take your children and turn them away from the truth. You will turn those children away from Jesus Christ, the way, the truth, and the life. You are afraid to step up here and get a piece of paper that will tell you what God wants from you. And you are a fool to turn away the ways of God. A little piece of paper, and you reject to tell you what God expects of your life, you're a fool. The way of salvation is right here on this island. It is Jesus Christ, the Bible, the gospel that's printed out for you. There is none good. There is none righteous. There is none that seek after God, the Bible says, Romans chapter 3. If you were to seek after God, why would God tell His Bible-believing, saved people, go ye in all the world and preach the gospel? Because you ain't searching. You have no idea. You might get to worship the great Cadbury egg instead of Jesus Christ. Man does not search for God. They find a God that accompanies their sin. They try to find a God that will go along with what they're doing wrong and is pleased. I heard this week that it is said of Christians that they will call Jesus into their life, but they will not be called in the life of Jesus Christ. That's a sin. That is blasphemy. God has called us to be holy. You are wanting God to be a holy baloney. And God is much better than that. God is not baloney. He is bread. He is water. He is honey. He is meat. He is holy indeed. And He says in His word, be ye holy, for I am holy. And the mess that your church is going to do this week or next week is not holy. Easter is not a Christian word. Unless you worship idols and images. I don't think you're going to show your children that image of Esther. That woman that's Esther, she's more pornographic than the Playboy magazine, I'll tell you that. Hey, I'm only trying to teach you the truth. You've got your children, you've got your churches, and vile filth of paganism today. And you don't have Jesus Christ. And if you do have a Jesus Christ, Paul tells us in the letter to the Corinthians that there's another Jesus. And a Jesus that does not go along with the Bible is another Jesus. That Jesus will not save you. That Jesus will be cast off into hell with you. You need the Jesus that's of the Bible, that's been virgin born, that is sent by God, that is God. Acts 20:28. A Jesus that went to Calvary's cross for sin. A Jesus that is the Lamb of God, which take away the sin in the world. Sorry, Rabbit. Salvation's for Jesus. Tricks are for Satan. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For these things I have written unto you, that you might know you have eternal life. The church is infested with the worship of Satan. And Jesus Christ, according to Revelation chapter 3, is outside of that church, knocking. You say, "Mister, why don't you go take this to the church house? It's not Sunday, it's a Saturday. Go preach in the church house." No, the Bible says, go in all the world and preach the gospel. 90% of you are not even going to ever be inside of a church. And you're not going to pick up this kind of message on the radio or TV, so we will bring it to you. And we'll bring the message that Jesus saves. And Jesus alone saves. According to the scripture. That there is no other way of salvation of that is wrought in Jesus Christ. The message of God is believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to be saved. Saved from what? There's hell coming. If you reject or deny Jesus Christ, hell is coming for you. The Bible says death and hell in that order. You will die and you will wake up in hell and you will never come out and you'll realize that this planet Earth is not hell. And you can get out of this planet Earth. You cannot get out of hell. You can die in Christ and go be with the Lord presently. There is no sin that Jesus Christ can't wash. And when you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, you are sealed. You are sealed under the day of redemption when the Lord calls you home. You can't lose it. You can't misplace it. God can't give you up. You are signed, sealed, and delivered by the way of Jesus Christ through the finished work of Calvary's cross. There is no other way that you can be saved. Satan, in your own mind, wants you to think, whatever. But God does not do whatever. Proverbs says a way that what the ideas of man he thinks is right, but the ways thereof is death. You can come up with anything you want to come up, but if it's not God approved, it's not going to get through. And when the Bible speaks about go ye in all the world and preach the gospel, God is saying reach out to those people and tell them there is a way. I don't care what they've been taught. I don't care what they say. I don't care. But Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. Preach that message and tell them. And they reject the message and you, I will cast them into the lake of fire that burneth forever for their rejection of the finished work that my Son has done for them. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. That is the love of God. The hatred of Satan is anything else but Jesus Christ. Heck, Satan will even say, I'll give you another Jesus. I'll give you a Jesus to your liking. Satan's way. The Satan's way is a way that leadeth to destruction, because that's the way he's going.
Hi, guys.
How you doing?
You know anything about Constantine?
Yes.
Then we can discuss things. Because if somebody didn't know that, then they don't know what they're talking about. But you're doing a good job, man.
Yeah, Constantine's the one that brought the Easter bunnies and the paganism into the church, so I don't kill you.
Exactly. Yep. Exactly. I studied under Dr. Gene Scott. He died a few years ago. But he took everything to original words, original meanings, and Jesus is my Savior.
Amen. Amen.
I tell you, have a good day.
You too now. Satan will give you anything else but Jesus. And it pleases the little kiddies. Because we sure don't want the kiddies to sing, Jesus loves me, this I know. We don't want our children to sing that. We want our children to sing Rudolph and up on the housetop, click, click, click. I just shot old Saint Nick. And in Florida, my chocolate bunny did melt. Come on, people. Open up your internet and check Easter and Esther. I guarantee, check it. Look up what Easter is in the encyclopedia. And you'll be shocked. You're so stupid with your smartphones, you won't look up the truth. Because you'll take anything but Jesus Christ. You'll trust in anything but of God. And your trust and your thoughts will go to hell with you. You'll believe the words of man before you believe the words of God. Come on, people. The way of God is Jesus Christ. It ain't anything else. Everything that you see, everything that you feel, everything that you taste is a gift of God, and you won't even thank Him for it. It came from farmers. Yeah, but who gave us the farmers? Who gave the farmer the brain to know how to take care of fruits and vegetables? Oh, a big bang. Now the world goes in a big bang according to the Bible. You were born to die. That's it. I don't care all your accomplishments. I don't care of all your achievements. You were born to die. What you do before you die will settle your eternity. Between the age of accountability that you know that you have sinned against God to the day that you die, if you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, you'll be absent from the body and present with the Lord. If you reject Jesus Christ, you will wake up in hell. That's simple. And notice, I'm not preaching Daniel's 70th week. I am not preaching about the crowns. I'm not preaching about the vials, the book of Revelation. I am talking about one prophecy of the Bible. Without Jesus Christ, you'll burn in hell. How's that for a prophecy? Let's see your television preachers do that about prophecy. A man that dies without Christ will go into hell. You won't find it. They're probably going to that place that they don't preach about. They'll air condition the place that they're going to. But you will not find a prophecy about hell on that radio dial or on that TV dial. And you're sure not going to find hell on Easter weekend. You're going to find a fluffy, doofy, goofy, sugary, deadly religion. It is wicked. wicked in the eyes of God what these churches are doing today. Back in my grandma's time, they would yell, Amen! Today they yell, Bingo! That's wicked! And some of you that are going to be in the church tomorrow are just as wicked as what your church does on the average Sunday. You cannot have a sugary church and not be a diabetic church. You gotta be a Christ-honoring, Christ-loving, Christ-centered church, and that's not what these churches in America are today. You wouldn't have a place for 10,000 seats if you were Christ-honoring, Christ-centered. Preach the gospel! Lift up your voice like a trumpet and proclaim to people their sins! Isaiah! There's a woman that doesn't know anything about a Bible believing church. Only the Pharisees told Jesus, don't say it. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. That's the love of God. The love of God is Jesus Christ went to that Calvary. Jesus Christ died upon Calvary according to the scriptures. He was buried. And 3 days later, he arose from that grave, according to the scriptures. That's the love of God. Nothing artificial. It is great for your health. It is great for your soul. It is great for eternity to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. And yet the Bible says, who has believed our report? None of you. He was bruised for our iniquities. And God will bruise you for rejecting what he has done. With his stripes we are healed. Rejecting those stripes of Jesus Christ, you'll never be healed. You will suffer for all eternity. Because you have not believed on the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, believing in the Lord Jesus Christ, you get to be with God. You get the painlessness. You get the tears no more. Sorrow will be gone in eternity. You will be forever with the one that created you. You'll be forever one that died for you. You'll be the one forever that loved you if you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. And by you want that message shut up. And the Bible says you want this message shut up, so you proclaim what the Bible says. Thank you. But you would not reject me up here with a table with a bunch of Easter eggs and a bunch of bunnies free for your children. You would love that. You would honor that. You would be praising for that. But when we preach Jesus Christ, they say that, shish. Why? Why does Jesus Christ in the Bible offend you? Because of holiness. And you're not. You want a Jesus Christ or a God that goes with your filthy sin. And I ain't going to preach that Jesus. I will never lay that Jesus that enjoys your sins. I will preach Jesus that washes us from our sins, that calls you to repent of your sins, to turn or burn. That's the Jesus of the Bible. That is the Jesus I will preach. And if you don't like it, you'll face that Jesus. But the Bible says, prepare to meet thy God. Oh, preacher, you're so angry. Wait till you face God rejecting his son. Wait till you face the God that will proclaim before you, depart from me, ye workers of iniquity. I never knew you. Go to hell. Go jump in the lake. I'd like to face that God. You think he'd be sweet, loving, and caring? I trow not. Thank you. You one day think that a preacher came out to you. Some of you to salvation, and some of you to damnation. Salvation is simple. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Everything else will get you damnation, condemnation, and tormented. You've got to come to Jesus as the sinner that you are and repent. You can't come to Jesus how good I am. You can't come to Jesus here and put him in my mouth. You can't come to Jesus by his family. You've got to come to Jesus who is God, and you've got to come to him as a sinner. If you haven't done that, you're not saved. I don't care what prayers you said. My church doesn't preach that. Well, thank God you're finally hearing Bible preaching. You got to go to a farmer's market here to Bible preach. Praise God, there's truth. Imagine some of you professing to be Christians and you hate what's being preached out of the Bible about Jesus Christ, Christians, and you hate the Bible being preached. Wow. I wonder where you're going to go. And this is the message of God, that Jesus saves. The Bible says, Acts 16:30-31, what must I do to be saved? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, thou shalt be saved. There's no cash, there's no credit, there's no checks taken at the gates of heaven. It is always by the blood of Jesus Christ. That's it. It is the sacrifice that Jesus Christ made on that cross once for sinners. You've got to come to realize you're going to die. And I guarantee when you die, you will be a Bible believer. Too late. When you die, you'll know that Jesus saved. Too late. Like someone will learn, hey, look at what this knife can do. It can chop off my fingers. Too late. Sometimes things in life you learn too late. And when you're in hell, then you realize that, yes, that preacher's correct. Jesus saved. Too late. The time to trust Jesus is before the grave. Before you die. And the loving God has sent preachers out to tell you what to do before you die. Yes, man comes with an instruction book, the King James 1611 Bible. That is the instruction book. And the instructions say how not to go to hell. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. Instruction number one, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. Come to God as the sinner that you are. Come now. Let us reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. That is God speaking to you, sinner. That one sin that will damn you is the sin that you will not believe on Jesus Christ. as your sins mount up. When you stand before God and you got to give an account for what you're saying and how you're reacting to the preaching today and last week and the week before. The Holy God of the Bible will hold you account for what you say, what you do, even your thoughts. Every idle word shall be judged out of a man's mouth, the Bible says in Matthew. Every idle word, every thought. And you don't realize your rejection of the Word of God, your hatred toward the Word of God, I know it's happening right now. You will be brought to God on how you're conducting yourself with His Word. It don't bother me. It bothers God. And you're too stupid to realize that God is the way. You're too stupid Americanized to say, oh, you're so important. You think you're better than God. You think God will come down off that throne and bow down before you. You're a fool. That's what you think, because you're not stepping out to believe on God. What other conclusion is there for you not to come to God and be saved? You must be so important than God. Well, God, my religion is much better than Calvary. I don't need Jesus. I got Calvary. I got cash. I'm smart. I'm American. I can get by Jesus. There are no Americans in heaven. Oh, look what Saddam is doing over there in Syria. Isn't it terrible? What's he doing with those bombs? And yet America dropped how many atom bombs on Japan? How many nuclear tests were done on its citizens in Nevada? You think that nation is more stronger than God and Jesus Christ? You're a fool. You think Donald Trump can save your soul? He won't even go to church. He won't even profess Jesus Christ. Listen, people, I've written every president since Ronald Reagan about their soul. Two presidents have not responded. Obama and Trump. They don't dare write me about Jesus Christ. Both of them. Ronald Reagan wrote me. Bush Jr. wrote me two times. How about Jesus Christ?
You know, I had a dream this morning, and I took your place. I was reading all scriptures and stuff. It was really cool. So I think about you, buddy.
Thank you.
God bless you, folks. Keep it
Thank
up.
You. You see, many of you think this message is hate. No, this message is hated by Satan. Because if there's one thing Satan does not want, he does not want you to honor God. He does not want you to be pulled out of his hell. Satan hates God and Jesus Christ. And Satan does not rule, because I read the end of the book. He loses. He'll end up in the same place where you're going without Jesus Christ. But I never read in the Bible where Satan drinks beer or anything. I don't see him as a bartender. Matter of fact, if my Bible's correct, Satan never goes into a bar. Satan's more interested in churches than he are the bars. Kind of interesting, isn't it? Satan's arch enemy is God and his son, Jesus Christ. And what he will give you is propaganda, which has worked in military forces, to believe not the lie. And his lie is that Jesus will not save you. I'll give you something else that will save. And that's a lie. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Death is coming. We don't know when. You do not know when death will call. But you will die. My advice to you, according to the Bible, you better die in Christ. If you don't die with Christ, you're going to die in crisis. And you'll never come out. As when Satan will be cast in the lake of fire, he will never come out. You know what Satan's joy? For you to be damned forever. So what is Satan's religion? I'll tell you what Satan proclaims as a religion. Are you ready? He proclaims to his people, go to hell. Jesus says, we will show you how not to go to hell. Oh, I don't believe in hell. Go to hell. Go to hell. Go to hell. Why are you saying it? Some of your co-workers believe in hell because they tell you to go there. That's how you know there's a hell. That's where people tell you to go, by the orders of Satan. Satan will have men tell you go to hell. God says tell them how not to go to hell. Look at that. And you hate the man that says do not go to hell. You hate the God that says believe on my Son to be saved. You hate the God that says there's no Santa Claus, there's no Easter, there's no toys, there's no games. You hate that God because he's righteous and he's holy and you are not. But you love the God that loves your sin. You want the God that will sit down and drink a beer with you. And you'll say, oh, yeah, in hell, we're going to drink beer. Well, that's your God, that's your place, you won't drink beer. Nice thought. I've got nice thoughts, too. I like to be 100 pounds. That's a nice thought. Ain't going to happen. Never going to happen. I'll never see 150. Never going to happen. We got such nice thoughts and dreams. And according to the Bible, our thoughts and dreams, if it's not settled by Jesus Christ, it will be settled in the lake of fire that burns forever. And you can take your religion to hell with you. You can take your popes to hell with you. You can take your Chai Ching and all your Buddha stuff like that with you to hell. Because that's not the way of God. You say, well, how do you know my religion is not going to save me? How do you know my religion is not going to work? Because my way of salvation is spelled J-E-S-U-S. Your salvation, your way of being saved is spelled D-A-M-N. That's the difference. You will die. You will, after your death, approach eternity. What you do before you die will settle your eternity. You cannot change your eternity. Your eternity can be only changed what you do before you die. In order to get out of hell, you've got to come to Jesus Christ and repent of your sins. There is one way out of hell. It's Jesus Christ. The Jesus Christ of the Scriptures. The Jesus Christ that is sent by God. The Jesus Christ that died for our sins. According to the Scriptures. The Jesus Christ that was buried. The Jesus Christ that arose from the grave 3 days according to the Scriptures. That's the way of salvation. The very same Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except by me. That's Jesus speaking. Jesus also said that ye must be born again. You were born to die. Your birth was in sin. You were born wrong. You need a spiritual birth, and that is accessed by Calvary through the finished work of Jesus Christ coming to God as the sinner that you are. You don't come to Jesus as my homeboy, my bro, the man upstairs. You approach Jesus Christ sacredly as God, as you a sinner, on your knees, repenting before God Himself. That's how you come to Jesus Christ. You don't come to Jesus with your mouth open to be placed on your tongue. That's cannibalism. You don't come to Jesus by killing His people. That's not Jesus. That's Satan. The Bible says he's a liar and a murderer. So a religion that says kill people, gee, I wonder who he's under, according to John 8:44. Gospel of John 8:44. The murderer is Satan. That goes for the Catholic Church, too, for murdering Christians. That's not taught in school. Inquisition. Religion says, kill. God says, my son shall die for you. Religion says, oh, I'm so good. The Bible says there's none good. No, not one. There is a strong difference between what you believe and what the Bible says. And what God says through His Word will last for all eternity. Heaven and earth may pass away, but my Word shall never pass away. The Bible will outstand Mother Earth. Mother Earth will be destroyed, burnt up, gone. Can't save her. Whales will die. You can't save them. But Jesus Christ can save your soul. Save your soul from what? Hell. There is a hell. All is not well. There is a hell. And without Jesus Christ, you will go there. I said, to God, Jesus Christ, you repenting as the sinner that you are. Behold the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world. What can wash you of your sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. At Calvary, where mercy is free and grace is abundant. Yes, God will take. There is no sin that God cannot wash from you to save you. You are not so vile that God will say, no, can't take you. Satan wants you to say, oh, God won't take you. You come to God as you are a sinner and put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ. Repent of those sins and God will receive you. God will seal you. God will accept you as one of His children. There is no sin that God cannot save from. For the Lamb of God which take away the sin of the world. If we shall confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins. I know there's two scales. I know that people say, oh, I never sin. And there are people say, well, I'm just too wicked for God. You're both liars. All have sinned. And for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in Him should not perish, whosoever believeth. Come to God with your sins and place them under the blood of Jesus Christ. Come. Come now. You don't know when death is coming. And death is coming. Look at your watch. You are one more second closer to dead than you were a second ago. When you woke up this morning, you're one day closer to your death. And you will die. We don't know when. That's why the Bible says, behold, now is the time of salvation. Come now. Because we don't know when. And when death comes, you can't be saved after. There is no salvation after you die. Even the rich man in hell wanted mercy and grace, and he never got it. You must believe on Jesus by faith before you die. And you don't know when you're going to die. So how about now? Listen, I don't know how many years we've been doing this, but I guarantee there's some people here that have heard us and are now dead. They have died. And if they've died in the Lord, they say, hallelujah, preach it. Keep preaching. You're right. I wish they would listen. But if they have not believed on Jesus, they're in hell. And they're saying, oh, if we could only listen to Him. And according to Jesus with a rich man in hell, the Bible proclaims that those people who died and went to hell are saying, hey, will you guys listen to Him? People in hell do not want you to come. According to Jesus Christ. So if Jesus said that people in hell don't want you to come, how on earth do you think you're going to party with them when you're going to anger them by coming when you hear a Bible preacher preach to you the truth? You defy God by going to hell, and you defy your family and friends that are already in hell. You think you're going to party with them? They're going to kick you in the butt for all eternity for not believing the Bible. The man in hell, according to Jesus, said, go tell my brethren. Tell them about this place of torment. Oh, I believe that they come from the dead. He tried that. He said, well, you send somebody from the dead, that can't do that. But God says, I'll do something better. What's that? I'll send a living person who has believed on me. I will send him to you that you might believe on my son. That's better than coming from the dead. Because I have a better testimony than someone who's died. I've been saved since 1987 in April. Hey, April, 1987. Oh. I'm having a spiritual birthday party soon. Unlike the foolish birthday we did last week. The fool is in his heart, there's no God.
I've got one already.
I'm going to be 30 years old in Christ. I think after 30 years of reading and studying the Bible and doing what God has told me to do, I think I can speak about Christianity and what the Bible says. Now, I'll tell you what the Bible says after 30 years. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. That's the same message that was preached to me on a Saturday afternoon that I received Christ as my Savior. No doodads, no rewards, no candy, no tickets. Just believe on Jesus Christ and you will get out of hell. Thank you. Praise God. 30 years coming up. And it's sweeter than it was the day I got saved. It's a honey sweeter. It's natural. No artificial. No additive. There's no religion in my salvation. There's nothing that was put in by man for me to be saved. It was all of God. All of His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, was I saved on that afternoon. By the precious blood of Jesus Christ without spot, the Lamb of God, which take away the sin of the world, took away my sin 30 years ago. And He could take away your sin right now. Step out. Come to God as a sinner. We will open up the Bible. We will show you what to do to believe on God. Come out. And you can have your name written down in the Lamb's Book of Life so that when you die, you'll pass from hell to heaven. Step out as the sinner that you are. If you don't, you will regret it for all eternity. You will never forget what you passed up if you go to hell. It will always be on your mind that you rejected Jesus Christ in hell. It will be forever in hell that you will be minded that you hated Jesus Christ. It will be always in eternity in hell that you told God you don't need Him. Or you could spend eternity thanking God, praising God, glorifying God in a new body, without tears, without fear, without anguish, without anxiety, without pain, without sorrow, for eternity singing and praising the God that loved you upon the cross, that finished the work at the empty tomb. You can have love by Jesus, or you can have hate by Satan. It's your choice. But don't be fooled. Satan wants you to think that he has love and God hates you. Don't go for the lie by the liar, John 8:44. Once you die, it's too late. It is too late. You cannot undo what you didn't do before you died. Death is more sure than taxes. You can die before April 15th. You may die before April 15th.
May even die today.
That's right.
So it's good to be always prepared.
Yep. You may have life insurance, but do you have death insurance where Jesus paid that premium? Victory over death is in the Son of God, who is God, Jesus Christ. Show me the policy, preacher. Right here. That's the death insurance policy right there. It's the Bible. You know, you're not sure after you die if your life insurance will give your family the money that you did. You're not sure. You're dead. You don't know. They may not give your family the money. But I knew 100% by the death insurance of Jesus Christ, when I die, I'm going to heaven by that death insurance. I know that. And I know my family knows that if I were to die, I'd be in heaven. But better than life insurance. Life insurance is good as only when you die. Death insurance is good for all eternity. Death insurance gets me a new body. Death insurance will get me no pain. Death insurance by Jesus Christ will get me no sorrow. Your life insurance may destroy your family. You may get them $10,000 and they may do stupidness with it. You're not guaranteed how well they'll be. They might put you in an ass can and spend the money wrongly. They may spend all the money to fight the money in court. But if you're to get death insurance by Jesus Christ, it's settled. It was settled long ago upon the cross. The cross of Calvary. By the entombment of Jesus Christ. And by the angels proclaiming, He is not here, He is risen. That's the gospel. It was all done according to the scriptures. You and your God, Satan, does everything by anti-scripture. There is no hope without Jesus Christ. For the hope is, the blessed hope is Jesus Christ, Titus 2:13. Your eternal rest, lies upon the finished work of Jesus Christ. You will not rest in peace if you reject Jesus Christ. I don't care if they put that on your tomb, R.I.P. Without Jesus Christ, you will be in no rest, eternity. If you die without Jesus Christ and they put R.I.P. on your tombstone, they are lying. God is unable, cannot, will not ever lie. And He says those that reject Jesus Christ will suffer the wrath of God. Now, you want to rest in peace? Put the finished work upon Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. And you'll be more than resting. You'll be glorified. You'll be hallelujah. You'll be jumping up and down, praising God. What a rest. You'll be without sin. All joy. You won't need patience. All if you settle your account with Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, today. It may not be a tomorrow. You may not live any longer. Settle that account now. So when death does come knocking, you'll open that door and say, welcome. absent from the body and present with the Lord. Hallelujah. You're a fool to pass up these tracts about Jesus Christ. I read that last week. Proverbs chapter 1. But if we were handed out free NASCAR tickets, you'd devour them. If I gave out free coupons for McDonald's, you'd devour them. You are a fool to reject God and His Word. God said that, not me. I just enjoy saying that. I can biblically call you a fool for rejecting Jesus Christ and say it with a smile. I'd like you to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, but I can only preach the gospel. I can't force you. You are what you are, and the Bible says without Jesus Christ, you're a fool. And your birthday was last week. Don't get me going.